الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وأصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, today's reflection is going to be on the famous hadith that Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated في صحيحيهما in their most authentic book. And it's a hadith jami', it's a very comprehensive hadith. And this hadith has gathered in it many virtues and many righteous deeds. And it's the hadith which speaks about the seven in which Allah will give them a shade the day when there is no shade. The seven people that Allah is going to give them a shade when there is no shade the day of judgment. Al-Imam Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah, he has a kitab called At-Tamhid. And this kitab At-Tamhid, written by Ibn Abdul Barr, it's the explanation of the kitab Al-Muwatta li Imam Malik rahimahullah. Ibn Abdul Barr, he said about this hadith, the hadith that Allah is going to give a shade to seven type of people, he said, هذا أحسن حديث يروى في فضائل الأعمال وأعمها وأصحها إن شاء الله وأحسبك به فضلا وحسبك به فضلا لأن العلم محيط بأن كل من كان في ظل الله يوم القيامة لم ينله هول الموقف. ابن عبد البر رحمه الله said, هذا أحسن, this hadith is the greatest, one of the greatest hadith yurwa fi fada'il al-a'mal, that speaks about virtuous deeds. Wa'ammuha is one of the most comprehensive. Wa'asahruha is one of the most authentic. Insha'Allah, if Allah wills, he said. Wa'hasbuka bihi fadla, this hadith alone is sufficient for you virtue. Hadith is enough. لأن العلم محيط لأن كل من كان في ظل الله يوم القيامة. Because knowledge encompasses that the person who is under the shade of Allah the day of judgment, لم ينله, it will not come to him. أما he will not go through هول الموقف, the harm and the pain and the agony of the day of judgment. Until he said, Ibn Abdul Barr, جعلنا منهم, oh Allah, make us from those people, برحمته آمين. Oh Allah, make us from those people in which you place under the shade the day when there is no shade, except the person who Allah gives them a shade. And we say the same, may Allah make us from the people in which He gives them a shade that day. This hadith, ya ikhwa, is عظيم للغاية. This hadith is great and it's immense. And it is worth not just one sit like today, but it deserves for it to be made into halaqat. Many sits in which we talk about each one in depth. But as I said before, these reflections are only meant to be for a very short minute, a little bit. The aim behind it is not to go into great details. And some people, they think that the people Allah is going to give the shade are only these seven. And that isn't the case. Al-Imam As-Sakhawi rahimahullah, he's the student of Hafidh ibn Hajar rahimahullah. He's his student. He wrote a book on roughly 70 people Allah is going to give them the shade the day of judgment. Jalaluddin As-Suyuti, who was a mu'asir, he was the same time as Sakhawi, he also wrote a book on this issue. So they're not only seven, they are more than seven. Because there's a famous hadith, Al-Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, that the Prophet said, من أنظر معسرا أو وضع عنه أذله الله أذله الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. The person أنظر معسرا, he respites. A person who is poverty stricken, or وضع عنه, or he remissions him. أذله الله, Allah is going to give you a shelter. في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. The day when there is no shelter except the person Allah gives him a ظل, a shelter. Or so it's more than these seven. But let's go through the hadith and inshallah stand over the seven بإذن الله الكريم. The Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام سبعة seven يظلهم الله في ظله. Allah is going to give them a shade يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. The day when there is no shade except the person who Allah gives them a shade. The first is إمام عادل, a just leader. وشاب, a young, a youth. نشأ في عبادة الله, he grew up in the worship of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ورجل, a man, قلبه معلق في المساجد, a man whose heart is connected to the masjid. ورجلان تحابا, and two men who have loved one another. في الله, for the sake of Allah. اجتمع عليه, they came together on that love. وتفرق عليه, and they departed with each other on that love. ورجل, a man, دعته امرأة, a woman called him. ذات منصب وجمال, a woman who possesses a position, and a woman who is beautiful. فقال, he said to her, إني أخاف الله, I fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ورجل, a man, تصدق بصدقة, he gave a charity. فأخفاها, he concealed it and he hid it. حتى لا تعلم شماله, until his left hand does not know ما تنفق يمينه, that which his right hand gives. And this hadith, it fell in Sahih al-Bukhari مقلوبا. It fell in Sahih al-Bukhari back to front. Bukhari, he narrated it. حتى لا تعلم يمينه ما تنفق شماله. And the ulama, they consider that to be a hadith which is maqloob. It went back to front. ورجل أيمان ذكر الله, he remembered Allah خاليا, alone, nobody with him. ففاضت عيناه, and his eyes, they watered. ففاضت means his eyes gushed with tears. This is the hadith that we're going to, بإذن الله الكريم, take. Let's start over the first one, which is Al-Imam Al-Adil, the just leader. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started with the just leader. The reason is because the just leader is the one who is the closest to Allah the Day of Judgment. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith, Al-Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, إِنَّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَلَى مَنَابِرِ مِنْ نُورٍ عَنْ يَمِينِ الرَّحْمَنِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَكِلْتَا يَدَيْهِ يَمِينٌ الَّذِينَ يَعْدِلُونَ فِي حُكْمِهِمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ وَمَا وَلُوا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the people who are just, عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, they are fair and just and upright people. They are with their Lord, عَلَى مَنَابِرِ مِنْ نُورٍ, they are on pulpits that are out, made out of light. عَنْ يَمِينِ الرَّحْمَنِ, on the right of Allah عز وجل. وكلتا يديه يمين, and both of Allah's hands are right. And they are who? الذين, the ones, يعدلون, they are just, they are fair. في حكمهم, when they judge, when they judge between the people. وأهليهم, they are just to their family. And they are also just to what? وَمَا وَلُوا Whatever they govern and they control, they are just. Al-Allam ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions, أَهْلُ الْوِلَايَاتِ The people who have leadership are two types. There's a wilaya which is عَامَّة, a general leader. And that's the president, the king, the amir. That's a wilaya which is عَامَّة. He falls under this hadith, of course. But what also falls under this hadith is the person who has wilaya khasa, a person who is a leader in his own household. This hadith also encompasses, Ibn al-Qayyim says, rahimahullah. Even the one who judges between two people, the one who judges between two people. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he says in his kitab Minhaj al-Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah, that if a person, and he mentions in his majmu'ah as well, that if a person is judging between two of his children, his two sons, they come up to him and they say, Dad, which of us has a better handwriting? You are a leader. You're a judge. So you judge between them fairly. And if you don't, you're being unjust in the matter. ولذلك the Prophet ﷺ, he said to us, اِتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِيَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى Be conscious of him. وَعَدِلُوا بَيْنَ أَوْلَادِكُمْ Be fair between your children. Be just between your children. You're judging between your children, so be fair in how you deal with them. لذلك, if you look at many brothers who don't like each other, who don't have that love towards each other, it's because the parents, they played a role in dividing between the children. They didn't give their children the musawat. They weren't fair. They gave priority and they favored one child over the other. And it placed grudge in the heart of the brothers towards one another. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet ﷺ, when he was told to participate in a gift that was given to a child, the Prophet asked the parent, are you going to give it to the other children? And when they said yes, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, I do not participate in injustice. If what you're given is going to be for all of them, then yes, I'm coming and I'll participate. As for if you're trying to give it to some of the children and you're not going to give it to the rest, I don't participate in jawr, transgression and oppression. So everybody is a judge. ولذلك Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us in the Quran that the person is a hakim and a judge in his own actions. Allah says in the Quran, وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدٌ بِالْأُنْثَى ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ يَتَوَارَى مِنَ الْقَوْمِ مِنْ سُوءِ مَا بُشِّرَ بِهِ أَيُمْسِكُهُ عَلَى هُونٍ أَمْ يَدُسُّهُ فِي التُّرَابِ أَلَا سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ The person is a hakim in his own action. أَلَا سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ The fact that they bury their children alive and they put them under the earth, Allah referred to that as what? What an evil hukum they did. So the person needs to be upright in their actions and what they are doing. Every one of us is responsible. كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. Everybody is responsible and everybody will be asked the day of judgment about that responsibility that they have been placed over you. Parents will be asked the day of judgment. Allah is going to ask you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, your children, what have you done with them? Were you fair? Did you give them the upbringing that was needed? Or did you forsake the responsibility that was upon you? Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated min hadithi Ba'qal ibn Yasar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet said, ma min abdin yastar'ih lahu ra'iyah yamutu yawma yamutu huwa gha'ashun lil-ra'iyatih إلا حرم الله عليه الجنة. The Prophet said, "There is not a slave in which Allah places upon him a responsibility. Children, Allah is there from your responsibility. And he comes the day of judgment, وهو غاش للرعيتي, and he forsake the responsibility that were upon him. إلا حرم الله عليه الجنة. Except Allah makes Jannah haram from him. That's not a light issue." So everyone has a responsibility. The older brother has a responsibility towards his younger brother. Your older brother is following you. Your younger brother is following you. He's taking your footsteps. How many children were guided after Allah's permission because of what? Because of that which they saw from their older brother. And the same. How many sisters started to practice because their older sister was practicing? So the responsibility also falls on you as the older brother to set a good example for your brothers and sisters. The second part of the hadith is وَشَابٌ a youth نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. Some of the riwayat says نَشَأَ فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. A youth who grew up, he spent his life in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was a youth that did not get deceived by the glitters and the glamours of the dunya. وَلِذَلِكَ, if you ponder and you think over the ahadith of the Prophet, you always realize marhalatu shabab is always made to stand independent. Pay attention here. The hadith of Abi Barzat al-Aslami in Sahih Muslim. What did the Prophet say? لا يزول قدم أما لا تزول قدماي عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل. Some riwayat it says حتى يسأل عن أربع, and some riwayat it says حتى يسأل عن خمس. Five questions is going to be asked. What are the five questions that is going to be asked? عن عمره فيما أفنى. Your time, how did you spend it, right? And in the same hadith, you're going to be asked about your life. And in the same hadith, you're going to be asked against, about what? وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه. You're also going to be asked about your youth, how you spent it. But isn't the youth meant to be part of your في عمره فيما أفنى? Shouldn't it? Isn't it part of your umr, your life? But the Sharia, what did he do? I mean, the Prophet, what did he do? He made the shabab stand by itself, even that though it falls under, what? Even though it falls under the umr of the person. And it's like Surah Al-Fatiha that you all read. You read, everybody reads Surah Al-Fatiha in the Salah, right? Allah says, Iyaka, huh? Iyaka na'budu. Wa Iyaka نستعين. Isn't isti'ana ibadah? So why do we say إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ? Oh Allah, you we worship. And then we say إِيَّاكَ نَستعين, and you we seek refuge. And that we seek help from. Isn't isti'ana ibadah? Is it not a ibadah? Is it not? It is. Why is it taken out of ibadah? Huh? But if it falls under it, the fact that Allah mentioned ibadah would suffice it. We would know that isti'ana will fall under it. Emphasis. Huh? Emphasis. Ha. Scholars, they call this عَطْفُ الْخَاصِ عَلَى الْعَامِ. Huh? مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِي. What does Allah say after that? وجبريل. Isn't Jibreel and Mikael, are they not from the Malaika? Huh? Huh? They are, because like in Jibreel and Mikael, a group of people don't want to believe in them. So they are mentioned for that importance. Then the shabab here is taken out of the umr because of its what? Because of its ahmiyyah. Because of its importance and the weight that it holds. The Prophet said to us, alayhi salatu wasalam, اغتنم خمسا. Ya ikhwa, take benefit of five. قبل خمسين. Before five come. And the five that the Prophet mentioned from them is شبابك, this time that you have when you're young. قبل هرمك, before you become old, before you age and you become old. Benefit from what? This marhala, this stage that you're in. Allah tells us in the Quran, والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا. Those who strive in Allah's cause, subhanahu wa ta'ala, while they are shabab, Allah will guide you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to that which is good. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah is with those who come with excellency, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is not heedless. فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Allah is not heedless, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows what the criminals and the wrongdoers are doing. Allah knows today in the UK, the 21st century, in North London, You could have been going some other place and doing something which is wrong. But you consciously chose today to come to the masjid and to benefit and to remember Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward you. Even that though you have many things that are calling you to go towards the wrong direction, but you've consciously chosen to remember your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what then gives you the rights, the day of judgment, for Allah to give you a shade, the day when there is, when there's no shade. You deserve that. Because you chose to go against what your nafs wants, and you came to benefit from this time. The third one is رجل أيمان قلبه معلق في المساجد. أيمان, the scholars they mention معلق, it's taken from two words. أيمن التعليق, which is one, and some of them said وقيل العلاقة. معلق either is taken from تعليق, which is what it means is that the heart is actually dangling and it's connected to the masjid. It's in the masjid. And if something's in the masjid, every time it's going to come back there. Other scholars, they said, it comes from the word mu'allaq, ay alaqa. And the alaqa is a relationship, right? Ay mahabba. So what's bringing him to the masjid is mahabba, love. He has a alaqa, relationship with the masjid. And he keeps coming. Just like the person who has a relationship with somebody, they keep coming back to the person that they love. And this is khilaf al-tanawwu. That the person will keep coming to the masjid because his heart is connected to this place. If he goes out to do his worldly gain and he does what he has to do, he comes back to what? He comes back to the masjid. His heart is connected to the masjid. Brothers, I want you to pay attention here. What did Allah, the Prophet say in his hadith? وَرَجُلٌ A man. This is the characteristics of a man. That he's in the masjid. It's a man who prays in the masjid. The women, they pray where? What's the best place for the woman? Home. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? فِي بُيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ. Ayah? رِجَال. Men. And then the characteristics of this person, he's a man. It's a man who comes to the masjid and prays in the masjid. But to be at home and praying with the women, not a characteristic of a man. So the Prophet ﷺ used وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. And Allah تبارك وتعالى used what? رِجَالٌ. Men. لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. They don't get carried away with their money and their dunya in what? In coming to the masjid and remembering Allah. By Allah, today look at the khutbatul jum'ah. If you go over the khutbatul jum'ah 2-3 minutes over the time that you do that, the khutbah normally finishes, everybody will come to you in the office. Brother, you lengthen the khutbatul jum'ah. Why is it so long for? Hatta to the extent that the people's hearts are absent. Everyone's looking at the time because he put a ticket on his car. He just wants the khutbah to come. To the extent, subhanAllah, I'm an imam of the masjid, so they call sometimes the office. So when they call, they ask me, what time is the salah? I say, what time is the salah? I tell them the khutbah time. He said, no, I want the salah. He just wants to come to the salah and pray. He doesn't want to listen to the khutbah. You see, so it's only Fridays they only come to the masjid. They only come to the masjid on Fridays. Huh? And when they come to the masjid on Friday, they only want to pray, they don't want to listen to the khutbah. But Allah said about the believing men, what did He say? لا تلهيهم رجال لا تلهيهم رجال يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. That the dunya and the glitters and the glamours of the dunya doesn't get in the way of what? Of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them. So don't lose these characteristics which you have. And the Prophet ﷺ used to find comfort and joy in coming to the masjid and praying. As the famous hadith says, وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. I would find comfort and warmth in the prayer. ولذلك, what did the Prophet used to say to Bilal? He would say, يَا بِلَالُ أَرِحْنَا بِالصَّلَاةِ. Bilal, bring us comfort, relaxation through the salah. We look at the salah as a burden. We look at it as a burden. ولذلك we call the salah أحكام التكليفية. صحيح. ولذلك ابن تيمية رحمه الله he dislikes the usage of أحكام التكليفي. There's no use the word تكليف because the أحكام of Allah shouldn't be تكليف, which is burden. It shouldn't be it. It should be something that the nafs wants. The Prophet used to love the salah alayhi salatu wasalam. قلبه معلق في المساجد. Every time that you come to the masjid, you'll see that person. He's always in the masjid. Every salah he's there, he's praying. He spends his time in the masjid. This person, the day of judgment, he deserves to be from the shade. Those who are given the shade, the day when there is no shade. And I told you this before, brothers, and I will repeat it again. The first step for deviation and the first step for corruption that a person will go through is when they find themselves not coming to the masjid. When you disconnect yourself from the masjid and you start to stay away from the masjid, you're now working and walking towards destruction. إِنَّ الذِّئْبَ يَأْكُلُ الْغَنَمُ الْقَاسِ. The wolf, what does it eat? It eats the goat that it's, or the sheep that's by itself. So if you cut off from the masjid, you're vulnerable and you're weak. The fourth. Are we on the fourth or the fifth? Yeah? We're on the fourth. Which is رَجُلَانِ تَحَابَّا فِي اللَّهِ. Two people. They love each other on what? They love each other for the sake of Allah. اِجْتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ. Nothing else brought them. Except the love of Allah is what brought them. وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ. And that's what they leave each other on. If you love somebody for the sake of Allah, and that's what brought you to this person, you will always find that this person and you will always be together. Your love will remain. But if you love this person for another reason, it goes. And it will part. It'll part away from both of you. That's why the Prophet said, "Oh, تَقُعُرَ الْإِيمَانِ الْحُبُّ فِي اللَّهِ وَالْبُغْضُ فِي اللَّهِ." The greatest branch of Iman is that you love somebody for the sake of Allah, and if you do not love them, you hate them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet said, مَنْ أَبْغَضَ لِلَّهِ وَأَعْضَى لِلَّهِ وَمَنَعَ لِلَّهِ فَقَدْ إِسْتَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ. Anyone who loves somebody for the sake of Allah, he gives for the sake of Allah, he withholds for the sake of Allah, this person has completed Iman. There's a hadith that reached حَدُّ التَّوَاتُرِ. It reached multitude narration. The Prophet said, ثَلَاثُ بَلْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. Three characteristics. If it's found in you, you have received the sweetness of al-Iman. مَنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ إِلَيْهِ مَنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَاهُمَا وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. Which is the second one that concerns us. The person, he loves a person, وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْءُ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. You love a person and you don't love them for no other sake except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the only reason why you like them and you love them. If you love a person for أغراض الدنيوي, it will go. As the poet said, وَمَا كَانَ لِلَّهِ دَامَ. Anything that is for the sake of Allah, it remains وَتَّصَلَ. It will always be connected. وَمَا كَانَ لِغَيْرِهِ انْقَطَعَ وَانْفَصَلَ. And anything that is for other than Allah, it will disconnect and it won't carry on forever. That's why many people, what happens to them? وَتَقَطَّعَتْ بِهِمُ الْأَسْبَابِ. Disconnection. They're not talking to each other. They turn away from each other. وَلِذَلِكَ I pondered and I realized one thing. The day of judgment, is your mother going to run away from you? يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. Everyone is going to run away from you. And everyone is going to turn their back on you. But Allah told us one type of people will not leave you. Allah tells us in the Quran, الأخلاء يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو إلا المتقين. The people of taqwa, that day they are together. Everyone else is an enemy towards one another. But the good, the righteous brother that you've befriended for the sake of Allah, both of you that day would want to be together. And you will stay together. Allah told us subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً, that the believers are what? They are brothers. But Allah also told us in that surah, things that can make that brotherhood go, or it can damage it. And Allah mentions in the same page, He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٍ مِّن قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُنَّ وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ وَمَن لَّمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Allah tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala, those of you who believe, لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٍ مِّن قَوْمٍ, don't mock each other, don't belittle your brother, don't put them down. لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٍ مِّن قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. It could happen that this person that you're mocking and that you're belittling and that you're saying he's nothing, who is he, what does he think he is, what does he know, what does he understand, this person that you're doing this to, it's possible that he's better than you, he's greater than you in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's greater than you. And the woman shouldn't do it to another woman. The woman that she's doing it to and that she's belittling and she's putting down, it could be possible, Allah, in the eyes of Allah, that they are greater than you are. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَلَا تَلَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ, don't throw at each other nicknames that the person doesn't like. You give him names, he doesn't like it. He told you, don't call me this name. Akhi, I don't like this name, don't call me it. And you're still calling him by the name he told you not to call him. وَلَا تَلَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُوبْ, and anyone who doesn't repent from that, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. You're a zalim, you're an oppressor. And these are one of the things that Muslims generally don't, especially the community that we're from, the Somali community, we love to joke. Joking is part of our nature. We agitate if we don't joke at somebody. And sometimes a person might joke and this other person may not like it. And it could possibly sometimes it can reach a point where the person stops practicing because of the jokes that you were joking them with. Or things that you said to them. You could have been the reason why this person doesn't come to the masjid anymore. Or this person is not taking their religion anymore. Because you were joking and they were not finding it a joke the way you were. They were not finding it amusing the way you were. So fattakullaha, fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and do not break the brotherly bond that should be there. It's amazing, Allah talks about that and what He say, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. And then after that, he mentioned, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّن قَوْمٍ. Because these are the things that can what? It can get rid of that brotherhood. The fifth characteristics that the people will gain the shade, the day of judgment is, رَجُولٌ أَيْمَانٌ دَعَتْهُ مُرَأَةٌ, a woman calls you, she calls you. ذَاتُ مَنْصِبٍ, this woman has a position. Okay? وَجَمَالٌ, and she's beautiful. فقال, then this person says, إني أخاف الله, I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This one is that the obstacles that are calling you to this, I mean the things that are calling you to this woman are great. She's a woman, she's of position. In other words, everybody wants her. She's got name, she's got reputation, she's known. She's calling you. And again, she's got beauty. And the reason why you left it is not because you're scared of HIV or you left it because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You didn't leave it because of any other external reasons. The only thing that made you not want to do this and made you withhold is the fear of Allah that was in your heart. وَلِذَلِكَ, the poet, he said, إِذَا مَا خَلَوْتَ الدَّهْرَ يَوْمًا فَلَا تَقُلْ. If you're by yourself one time, alone, in a dark room, don't say, خَلَوْتُ, I am alone. وَلَكِنْ قُلْ عَلَيَّ رَقِيبُ. But say, The one who is observing me, Allah is looking at me. ولذلك العلامة محمد الأمين الشنقيطي رحمه الله, he said أجمع العلماء. Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti said, أجمع العلماء. The scholars are unanimously in agreement that the أعظم واعظ, the greatest reminder for anybody, the most powerful reminder is مراقبة الله, knowing Allah is looking at you. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد ألا يعلم من خلقه هو اللطيف الخبير يعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور آيات محكمات. Each ayah is telling you Allah knows سبحانه وتعالى your affairs. ولذلك you guys all know the famous hadith of Thawban. Tabarani narrated his Mu'jam al-Kabir. Al-Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah authenticated in his hadith al-Sahihah. That the Prophet said, لَأَعْلَمَنَّ أَقْوَامُ مِنْ أُمَّتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. I know a people, the day of judgment. يَأْتُونَ, they will come بِأَعْمَال actions. As big as what? The mountain of Tihama. Big, good, big deeds. A lot of righteous deeds. يجعلها الله عز وجل هباء منثورا. Allah is going to make it like it doesn't exist. The Sahabas, they said, are these people not Muslims? The Sahabas asked that question, are these people who are going to come with righteous deeds as big as the mountain of Tihama and Allah is going to make it هباء منثورا, are they not Muslims? Why did the Sahabas ask that question? Because they know the Quran and they know Allah said in the Quran, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. Allah is talking about the disbelievers. As for the believers, what did Allah say in Surah Al-Haqaf? أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ نَتَقَبَّلُ عَنْهُمْ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا وَنَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ فِي أَصْحَابِ الْجَنَّةِ وَعْدَ الصِّدْقِ الَّذِي كَانُوا يُوعَدُونَ. That Allah, He accepts the righteous deeds of the believers. صحيح. So here Allah is saying, I'm going to make it nothing. So they must not be Muslims, because Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ نَتَقَبَّلُ عَنْهُمْ, we accept from the righteous believers. The only people Allah is actually, He makes it هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا are who? Huh? The disbelievers. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, they're not believers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they are believers. يُصَلُّونَ, they pray like you guys pray. وَيَصُومُونَ, and they fast كَمَا تَصُومُونَ, the way you guys fast. The Prophet then went on to say, وَلَهُمُ الْحَظُّ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. These people even, a step further, they pray at night. قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ, they remember Allah. They do extra things. They don't just do the obligation. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, وَلَكِنَّهُمْ إِذَا خَلَوْا بِمَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ انْتَهَكُوهَا. The problem with these people is, when they are alone by themselves, they don't remember Allah. Any haram that comes to their head, any sins that comes to their mind, whatever evil that they want to do, in that dark room, they do it. Not knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الظَّلَامَ يَرَاكَ. The one who created the dark room that you're in, He can see you. He created the dark. How are you thinking of hiding in His creation subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَلِذَلِكَ the Salafu had in Ummah, they used to be scared when they were alone. This individual, the woman, she calls him and he turns her down. And he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does he say to her? فَقَالَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. He doesn't have to say it to her verbally. He doesn't have to say to her, إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. Even if he says it in his heart, that when he wants to do it, he remembers Allah. The ayah encompasses what? The hadith encompasses both. It means both. Whether he says it to her, and if he does say it to her, then he's telling her to leave me alone. And if he says it to himself, and he walks away, it also means the same. And this, of course, goes in accordance to the story of who? نبي الله يوسف وراودته التي هو في بيتها عن نفسه وغلقت الأبواب وقالت هيت لك وادرسيتها قال معاذ الله. So Nabi Allah Yusuf, she called him. And when she called him, what did she say to him? وقالت, huh? She said to him, هيت لك. What did she say to him? Another قراءة is what? Huh? هيت لك, صح? Is that قراءة? Huh? Huh? Is it? نعم, it's a قراءة سبعية. هيت لك, it means أي تهيأت لك. I prepared myself for you. I dressed up for you. So what this woman did was, she dressed up for Nabi Allah Yusuf. She beautified herself. She put a lot of jewelry on for him. And Nabi Allah Yusuf, he turned her down. ولذلك Yusuf's situation is very strong. Because there were many reasons that Nabiullah Yusuf has had that was pushing him. Ma'adalika, he turned it down. Number one was that this woman, she beautified herself, as she said. Second is that she was a woman of what? Da'at, Mansib. She had a position. She was her husband was the Aziz. Number three is that غلقت الأبواب, all the doors she locked. So no one can see. No one can see, the doors are locked. Four, Yusuf was a sham. Five, he was what? كان في بلد غريب. Yusuf was in a land that it's not his own land. And when you're at a place no one knows you, you can do what you want. That's why people, they leave their country and they come to other countries to do haram. Huh? Some people, they travel from Muslim countries, Arab countries, they come here to do haram and they go back. Sahih? There's nobody knows them. They're gareeb. Strange. Sahih? They're strange. Yusuf, all of that was there. Did he do it? قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ, he said. A believer should be like that. And then look what he said. قَالَ رَبُّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ. قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ. Oh Allah, the sijn, the prison, is more greater for me than what? مِمَّا تَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ, that which is calling me to. So Nabi Allah Yusuf, he would prefer to go to what? He would prefer to go to prison, بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, instead of what? Instead of fulfilling his desires. The sixth one is رجل تصدق بصدقة, a man who gave a صدقة, فأخفاها, he hid the صدقة, حتى لا تعلم شماله ما تنفق يمينه, he hiding it so much that part of his body doesn't know what the other part gave, let alone anyone else finding out, his left doesn't know what the right gave, he's hiding it from even his left hand, that's how much he's hiding it, he doesn't tell anyone. And one of the things that can be like that is that if you know a person has a shop, and they have a shop, and they're selling products, going to them and saying, how much does this cost? And them telling you the price that it cost, and saying, this thing that you've given me, it deserves more, wallahi. I'll give you double it, extra. Take it, it deserves more. The extra that you've given him, with the intention of having sadaqah, it falls under this hadith. And it's good than when you just give somebody money on the streets. The reason is why Ibn al-Qayyim mentions is you're pushing this person to work. And you're energizing him on the importance of working and making money. And you've hid it from him. You didn't tell him what sadaqah. So even he doesn't know what you gave him was with the intention of what? Sadaqah. He might think that you think the product is this much. Or you misheard him. Huh? But with the intention of sadaqah, Ibn al-Qayyim says it falls under this hadith. Brothers, it's not about how much you give. It's really about with what intention you give it with. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Sabaqa dirhamun bi alf dirham." The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, "Sabaqa dirhamun." One dirham, it passed 1,000 dirham. Why? Because that one dirham was given with a great intention. And it's sad because nowadays with social media, sincerity is close to dying. If one person gives somebody something, he wants to get recorded. And he wants it to go up online. He wants everyone to know what he's done. Everything he does has to be out in public. Whatever he does, the person should be far from that. Last but not least, is the seventh characteristics. Is رَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا. A person who remembered Allah alone. فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ. And his eyes, they watered. This person, he was alone somewhere. He was sitting and he remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reason why he would cry is because he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He desires to meet his Lord, Allah tabaraka, to meet Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So he cries. Brothers, the people who cry, as Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, he mentioned, are people who came with righteous deeds. Ibn Hassan al-Basri said, "Inna al-mu'min, the believer, jama'a bayna ihsanin wa shafaqa." The believer, he combines between good actions and him being scared. As Allah said in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ. They are the ones who come with salah, they come with siyam, they come with zakat, they come with righteous deeds, and their qulub is what? Wajila. They're very scared. Allah yutaqabbala minhum. They are scared that it might not be accepted from them, that this action may not be taken. They're worried and they are concerned. So when they are by themselves, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so they cry. Abdullah ibn Abi Mulaika, he's a tabi'i. He said, أَدْرَقْتُ ثَلَاثِينَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. I met 30 of the companions. And each and every one of them, كَانَ يَخَافُ مِنَ النِّفَاقِ. He was scared of hypocrisy. 30 companions. And they were scared of hypocrisy. So the believer always has in his heart that fear, that concern, that worry. And he's always scared of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is there in the hadith, فَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا. He remembered Allah alone. If you think about it, sometimes you might cry when you're with people. But who cries when they're alone? No one can see them, by yourself. You just remember Allah and you just break into tears. Why is this specifically going to be given a shaheed the day of judgment? لِأَنَّهُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَى الْإِخْلَاصِ. Because this is closer to ikhlas. إِخْلَاصُنَا لِلَّهِ صَفِّ الْقَلْبَ مِنْ إِرَادَةٍ سِوَاهُ فَأَحْذَرْ يَا فَطِنْ. This person is the motive, the intent of why he did it is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else can see him except Allah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبَّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ, that he makes us from those who gives the shade the day of judgment when there is no shade. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he forgives us for our shortcomings. Anything which I have said that was wrong and incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.